I'm overwhelmed. I've just done a sort of a quick squiz, and it's overwhelmed me a little bit. So I'm a bit of a loss as to what to say about this exhibition, just in terms of the artistic aspects of it. You know, and I'm really good with that kind of stuff. But I must tell you that in the last while, I have myself struggled to find a way to express all this stuff, I think, and I think it's not unique to me. I think it's what we as South Africans, it's something that we face now in our lives, and we can't run away from it anymore, and we can't pretend anymore. We all are now left with a need to express what this experience for us is, this intensity that being a South African is, and how we make sense of that in a way that isn't trying to explain it to someone else, but to just put it out there, to just say, this moves within me, and here it is. And somehow, something about this exhibition echoes so strongly in my soul, just about my own search for that this evening, that I have very little to say about it on that level. But after having spoken to Jamie and Sarah and Julia on my show on Thursday, say your name again.
Sandra.
Sandra. Because you are Sandra, have a netto club. But after speaking to them on my show, I felt so inspired. I felt so that here is an example for all the committee meetings and all the debates and all the million and one reasons why things often don't get done. To kind of say, here is an example of just put your heart in there, believe in it, believe in each other, and together as South Africans, we do the impossible. And we do it with such integrity, and we can be such an example to the world. And I'm so inspired by these women, just speaking to them, that I want to plead with you from my heart, and I'm not speaking to you, darling. I want to plead from my heart that if anything speaks to you here this evening, buy it. I'm not going to... Not you, baby. Please. But everybody else. And I can say that publicly, she knows that I can. But everybody else, if it speaks to you in the littlest possible way, because, I'm going to tell you, it's about this. In all this stuff that I've been... Because living here, you do start to wonder about what was here before I was here, what gaze at the stars like I gaze at the stars now, and what wonderings were there, and what am I echoing just being here? Does throw us back to our beginnings, and our where are we from, and who are we, and why do we find ourselves here? And you know, we are blessed that we had a first people here who lived their lives like that. It wasn't a separate thing that they did. They didn't study this. It wasn't a stream of things. This was what they were living, that refined aspect of living, that so in touch with nature and rhythms and messages and signals and past and future and the oneness of all of us, the interconnectedness of everything that has life and some things that doesn't seem to. That I feel that when we confronted with this, when we confront it with people's expression of this, people presumably who have in a space that has allowed for that kind of creative expression to come to the fore, then it is our responsibility. It is our responsibility as fellow citizens to support that in whatever way we can. And we must just go. It is part of our glory. And we need to march in the street. Not march in the streets of Bethesda, but we also have to find, seriously, creative ways of affirming each other like that. So I want to say to you women, then of course the three of you spoke to me and you spoke to my soul, I want to say to you that whether you sell a million of these works or not, and I hope that you do, it has meant something to me that I can't yet express. I can't yet find the words for, but it has meant a deep, deep thing to me in my soul. And it's beautiful, and thank you. So, I have to introduce some people, and a man that needs no introduction, so I'm not going to, and I'm not saying that as kind of like a speaker thing. Please, ladies and gentlemen, Dennis Goldberg.
I like to sit. And I've actually written a speech. And I'm going to read it. I'm a patron of the Bethesda Arts Centre. I was a patron before it existed. I met Jenny 10 or 11 years ago. I ran a charity in London called Community of Art. It was very tiny. She wanted to run this project, set it up, and we provided a little bit of strategic money, chairs and picture frames for their first exhibition. We're so tiny, we don't really count as early sponsors, you see. So I've known the project for a long time, and what amazed me is that it took a psychotherapist, Jenny, South African origin, who's lived in many countries, to recognize the need to unlock the vision of people with a different belief system. Here we have, you know, we talk, everybody knows about Greco-Roman myths and so on. And this is our world and our consciousness. And here we have artists who come from a different background, have a different vision of the world. And when I look at this wonderful picture here of the creation of the sun, by the sand understanding of some primordial being in the shape of a human, a woman no less, putting out her finger and sparking the sun into life. You know, I think Michelangelo must have known about sand mythology when he did the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. And he sparked just a mere human god into life, you know, not the sun that gives life to everything. You can see I'm reading that speech. And what I think is important, as Solly was saying, is that here are people who needed Jenny to unlock their vision. I think Jenny's done a phenomenal job. Directors don't get recognized, the artists do. And there are two of the 24 artists, Julia Malkas and Sandra Swears. Julia is the granddaughter of the Malkas, Kurs Malkas, who is not famous because he just did the wonderful cement and concrete sculptures at the Owl House in Nieu Bethesda. But he was just called the Huntlanger. He was never recognized. He was the artist. There's no question about it. She's written a book about it with Jenny. And Sandra, who has a vision, and you see the ease and the flair with which our artists, all 24 of them, men and women, handle this work. I think it's remarkable. And I think that the people of Nieu Bethesda, and I'm talking about the old guard, who will not recognize this project. Here are our artists who decolonized in their minds, able to express themselves, and the old colonizers won't recognize them. They have an exhibition there, they'll talk to Jenny, but not to the artists. They still don't count as people. They are the first people. It's outrageous, really outrageous. But here we have a commercial gallery with people of vision. Marika, John, and Peter Hagitai have given the gallery as a gift to do this show. They've even knocked out a wall upstairs to make room for a double triptych. I don't know what you call a double triptych. Is it a sextet? About the first man. And what's really significant about this is not just that they have taken sand mythology and given it expression. They've given it expression with contemporary relevance. And that's what's exciting for me. The first man, the one, this wonderful sex stick, is about a man who is a very poor hunter and captures a young lion to be his hunting dog, insists it's a dog. His wife says it's a lion. He says, woman, be quiet, obviously. What do women know about hunting? And of course, the lion turns on him and kills him. And of course, the family in itself is destroyed. And the contemporary relevance is we bring danger into the family. Violence, sexual abuse of women and children, alcohol. It has a relevance for them, and this comes out of their own daily lived experience. That's what they're saying to us. And so, what I find fascinating is expressing this collective memory of the origins of people. And I think it shows we all have pre-scientific visions of how we came to be, as Solly was saying. What was there before? And I think what they've done is an eye-opener. And so I want to thank the sponsors of this evening's event. There's the Pick and Pay, Ackerman Pick and Pay Foundation. And there's the Demersfontein Winery and Tukosa, their BEE Associated Winery. They've given us the wines. Just let me say, they want to share this privilege with you, all this wonderful wine. You can buy it at a 10% discount and you can take the orders. That is very important. We'd like to respond to our sponsors. There have been other sponsors as well, and that's Sentinal Experience. It's a local NGO in the field of art and culture. And you know, us old revolutionaries, Albie, we end up in the field of art and culture. And I say that mockingly because we used art and culture in our struggle. It was very important to us. And sometimes, having achieved our big goals, we forget about people. And Sandra and Julia, we try not to forget. The whole point is for you to express yourselves and everybody else. There are other people who have backed this art centre at Nieu Bethesda. The Constitutional Court commissioned a hanging. Judge Albie Sachs was instrumental in doing that. Thanks, Albie, very much. Sorry, we hanged a quilt, we didn't hang it. Breweries has bought stuff. And when you look at this double triptych, because I've made the joke too many times already, somebody needs to donate that to Parliament. The first people are at the centre of our national coat of arms. They really need to be... Can't do anything but hang them in Parliament, I'll be. Really need to be there. I want to thank them all. I want to thank Joy, my cousin, who did the publicity PR for this. And once again, the Hagatai family and their children who are here serving us. It's a great event. Thanks.
Will the GP, I'm talking here. Excuse me. Hello. Excuse me, I'm talking here. Fuck, hello. Hello. Oh, Lord, don't leave us.
They mustn't leave out the old mutual. They also sponsored. I'm so sorry. All protocol observed.
Oh, that obvious job. That's really fine. It's fine. Interrupt. Carry on. Forget stuff. You know. Am I completely in the way here? Yes. It's communal. You know what I mean? This is the thing about it. It's communal. Life goes on. Things are, so I was saying, just, I'm talking to the crowd at the back a little bit. Because shame. So we don't want to keep this too long, because apparently with like exhibitions, if you talk too much, then you don't sell paintings. But I did, and Jenny didn't want to speak, but I thought I really wanted her to say something. So don't not buy a painting because Jenny's going to say something. You know what I mean? Jenny Kazay, ladies and gentlemen. And now bring Sandra and Julia.
Thank you so much, Solly, and thank you so much, Dennis. What a wonderful opening. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you. And thank you all very much for being here. And thanks to Hout Bay, especially the gallery who's hosted this. I'd like to introduce the two artists that we have representing our project. My only sadness is that we haven't got all the artists here. But I'd like to introduce you first of all to our lead artist, Sandra Swears.
I just want to say thank you, and that I'm very glad that we've got the opportunity to have this exhibition here. And for everybody that helps with the exhibition, thank you very much. And I just want to say you make more than two people happy tonight. It's more than you make 27 people happy tonight. Thank you very much.
Okay, I'm Julia Malchas, and thank you, Soli, for making it kind of easier. Can I just put a bit of Afrikaans in there? Ek is van Bethesda, mens. Okay, it's I'm very happy to be here. So ek is baie bly om hier te wees. So Jenny gesê dat ons is regtig boesmans, hè. Maar ek voel 'n bietjie jammer dat ek my ma saamgebring het nie, want sy sou daarom gewys het hoe regte boesman aantrek het nie. Hierdie nuwe Mr. Price klere nie. So baie dankie, is goed om hier te wees, maar ek mis bietjie my kind 'n bietjie by die huis, so en ek hoop is te veel, ek is baie hastig op haar huis, dus so as jy nou wil koop nou. Dankie.
So I'm always accused of hogging the microphone, so if there's anybody else who feels the need, the spirit needs you, you want to say something, now would be a good time. Microphone. Jeff Ayler would like to give us the sports. No, I'm kidding. No, yeah, I suppose it's meaningful for me on many levels also because many years ago, and I was just listening to what Dennis was saying, many years ago when I was a struggling actor, not that I'm not still a struggling actor, but I mean I was a young struggling actor, you know, you get offered a work and you take it because it's what you want to do, it's your dream, you want to act, you want to do stuff like that, and so you take whatever you can get and you have to keep the pot boiling and you have to do all that stuff, and I was approached to do a role in For Few Gods Road to Mecca. And I played Kuis Mochas. And don't talk, because the thing about it is that in that movie, I think Kuis Mochas has four lines, maybe six, in the entire movie. And I remember running into one of my younger filmmakers many years after that, who said to me, he was so mad at me, he says, I saw you in that movie! I saw you in that movie, it's disgusting, Sullivan. How could you have been in that thing? Kuis Mochas was such an important component of what happened in that place, and he has eight lines in that movie, and you said it! And I was really, really taken aback, because the truth was that I didn't know Kuis Mochas' story. I did not know his story, and subsequently in my life, I've often been lacerated with that. Because I also had the good fortune, Jill was one of my kids' teachers, and so I got all her input, and she was very close friends with Ellen Martins, and I got all her input about queer. So it gave me many sleepless nights to think that on some level I started feeling guilty, so I'm feeling a sense of conspiring against this man who contributed so much to the art of our country. And I think for me, so that on that level, that this is his granddaughter, part of this year, of this expression, and part of the energy and the commitment, and yes, the money that you have put into this, and your life that you have put into this, and for everybody who believes into this, again, let me remind us, we have a responsibility. Please enjoy the rest of the evening here, and eat, and drink, and buy with us. Bye! Thank you for being here.
Kia le boha,
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 kia letsatsi ke a le boga ka letsatsi ke a le boga ka dijo tse re di jang ke a le boga
Oh, I'm not afraid to die. Oh, no. Thank you.